A wildcard certificate is the public key certificate that can be used with multiple subdomains of a domain. For example, if you own a devops.by.example.io domain, you can create a wildcard certificate that can be used with api.devops.by.example.io or hello.devops.by.example.io. Both those domains will get a green lock in the browser that indicates that the communication is secure. That certificate has to be issued by the well-known and trusted certificate authority, CA, such as Let's Encrypt. Your laptop, cell phone, or any other device has to trust the Let's Encrypt root certificate. If you want to get a certificate from the Let's Encrypt, you need to prove that you are the owner of the domain. To prove ownership of the domain to Let's Encrypt, you have few options. They usually call challenges. The first one is the HTTP/01 challenge. This is the most common challenge type today. Let's Encrypt gives you a token and you need to expose it on your web server. You need to have the following pattern: HTTP, your domain, well-known, Acme challenge, and token URL. Usually it is done with Acme client, which is automatic certificate management environment protocol. Let's Encrypt created a servbot for that purpose to automate the deployment of public key infrastructure. Let's Encrypt certificates are valid only for 90 days and they considering reducing the time due to the following concerns: to limit damage from compromised keys, since stolen keys and missed issued certificates are valid for shorter period of time; to encourage automation, which is absolutely essential for ease of use. Once the renewal is automated, shorter lifetimes won't be any less convenient than longer ones. Unfortunately, wildcard certificates can only be verified with the next DNS/01 challenge. This challenge asks you to prove that you control the DNS for your domain name by putting the specific value as a TXT record under the domain name. For example, if you want to get a wildcard certificate for the *devops.by.example.io domain, you need to create a TXT record for Acme challenge *devops.by.example.io with a random token that Let's Encrypt will generate for you. Keep in mind that every time you need to renew your certificate, which is every 60 days, you need to do it manually or use a plugin that supports your DNS provider, which can be tricky. In the next video, I'll show you a method to automate the renewal process that will work for all DNS providers and you don't need to store API keys locally. In that video, we will delegate DNS challenge to our own DNS server that will only answer TXT requests. Let's get started. All the commands and the source code is available in my GitHub repository. The link will be in description. I assume that you already have an Nginx and Servbot installed. If you don't, I highly encourage you to watch this video, how to secure Nginx with Let's Encrypt on Ubuntu 24 with Servbot. Let's verify that the Servbot is accessible. Most likely, you will get a higher version, which is fine. Always, when you're trying to get a certificate for the first time, use staging Let's Encrypt environment. Let's Encrypt has a strict certificate quota limit. Now, to test, just append test cert. This will validate that you can get a certificate. If you succeeded, you could safely rerun without that flag. Since I already tested it, I will remove it. Now, in this example, we will only get the certificate. It will not automatically update the Nginx server block. However, you can combine it with other plugins, such as Nginx. Manual indicates that we are not using any DNS plugins, and the preferred challenge is DNS, since that's the only one that is supported with wildcards. Now let's enter the real email for emergency notifications from the Let's Encrypt. We must agree with the term of service. Here you can optionally share your email if you wish. This is the most important step. We need to enter the domain for the certificate. Star here indicates that we want a wildcard certificate that will be valid for all subdomains. Next, we need to prove that we own this domain. We need to create a TXT record. My domain is hosted with Google Domains, so I'm gonna go there to create DNS records. The key is Acme challenge and the value is a random token. Let me paste the Acme challenge here under hostname, select TXT record and reduce time to live to 300 seconds. And finally the value, let me copy it from the output and paste it here and save. Now we need to wait a few minutes. It can be hard to measure how long because DNS hosting providers often use Anycast, which means multiple servers can have the same IP address and depending where you are in the world, you may talk to different server and get the different answer than Let's Encrypt does. Sometimes it may take up to 1 hour. I will wait maybe 5 minutes. Let's use the dig command to check the DNS resolution from our local machine. -t specifies that we're only interested in the TXT records. Short will only print out the value and finally the DNS record that we just created. we got the desired value, but again, it doesn't guarantee that the Let's Encrypt when resolve the DNS will reach the same DNS server and get the same response. Some DNS providers have API to check if the update is fully propagated among all DNS servers. Alright, let's press enter. We successfully received the certificate. It is stored under etc Let's Encrypt live divorce by example.io full chain, and we have a location of the private key. We will use both later when we start configuring the Nginx server block. You need to copy both those locations somewhere. Also, here is an important note that this cert will not be renewed automatically, as I mentioned before. To decode the certificate, optionally you can use the OpenSSL command and specify the path to the cert. Here you can see that the subject alternative name field that is mostly used by browsers to determine the domain is set to wildcard devops-by-example.io. Also, the common name is star.devops-by-example.io. Next, I want to create a simple HTML page and configure Nginx to use our certificates. Let's create a folder HTML. Then let's set the correct ownership and set permissions to 755. Now we can create an index.html page. As I said, it's incredibly simple, just a title and h1 tag. Now let's create an Nginx config and place it under conf.d directory. This will only work if you followed my previous tutorial and installed Nginx using the official Nginx repository and not the standard Ubuntu packages, since that one follows the traditional Apache setup with sites available and sites enabled directories. It is not a big difference, just a different folder structure. Let's create a simple server block and listen on port 80 for now. Then provide the path to the HTML files and specify the server name with a star. We want this server block to handle all the requests for all subdomains. To test Nginx config, run nginx-t. It looks valid, we can continue and reload it now using the -s reload command. It will reload the Nginx config without downtime. To test this configuration, we need to create a few subdomain DNS records. Let's call the first one API. It will be a record that points to the public IP address of the Nginx. My Nginx is hosted on AWS, so let me grab the IP address from there. And the second record, hello. It really can be any subdomain. Let's wait a few minutes and use dig to check the A records. You can use dig without -t flag since A records are default. It looks like we got it resolved, and check hello as well. Let's go to the browser and see if Nginx can return the correct page. To be safe, just use incognito mode in case you tried those domains before and they were cached by the browser. At this point, we can only use HTTP. Let's paste the API devops-by-example.io domain. Alright, it works. We got our index.html page. Let's check the hello subdomain. Okay, it works as well. What if we enter some garbage? It will return the error since we don't have the IP address associated with that. Also, what about HTTPS? No, it won't work just yet. Let's fix it. Go back to the terminal and open the Nginx config that we created. First, let's update port 80 to port 443 and specify SSL. That will require us to add certificate, private keys, and ciphers to the config. The first line is the location of the certificate that we received from the Let's Encrypt, then the private key. It was generated locally before CertBot sent a certificate request to the Let's Encrypt server. Then provide protocols that you want to support. Those are default, but you can adjust based on your security requirements. And finally, ciphers. Those are algorithms that help secure the network connection. Also, let's add another server block and configure the redirect from port 80 to port 443, since we want all communications to be secure. Now save and test the configuration. Oops, we got an error here. We missed the dot after star. Let's fix that. Test it again and reload. let's go back to the browser and refresh the page, since we already tried to use HTTPS here. We got a lock, means the cert is valid. Let's check the hello, it should work as well. Let's inspect the cert. Here you can see that the certificate is valid, and under details you can find the same alternative names with the wildcard as well as the common name. Please do me a favor and like the video, especially if you want more like that. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon in the next one. I'll show you how to automate renewal.